Hello friends, this video on synthetic fibers and plastics part 4 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Detail. So let us start with rayon. So rayon is also termed as artificial silk because it resembles silk, but it is not the natural silk. It is obtained, like if you talk about the natural silk, that is obtained from silkworm. So the process of extraction of silk from silkworm, that process itself is very costly, which makes natural silk very, very costly. But again, if you look at the quality of silk, it has got a very beautiful texture, a very attractive appearance. Because of that, a lot of demand is there for silk, for different types of garments, clothing, etc. So that is why somewhere in the 19th century, this artificial silk was developed for the first time. And rayon is the first man-made fiber. So it was the first fiber which was artificially manufactured by men. And if you look at its appearance, it looks exactly like silk. So this is how the rayon threads look like, and these threads are woven together to form the rayon fabric. So now let us see how rayon is produced. So rayon is primarily obtained from wood pulp. Now wood pulp, what is wood pulp? It is nothing but a plant source. So basically it is obtained from plant sources. Now plant sources, they are again naturally existing things. So this exists in nature, right? So since rayon is prepared from something which naturally exists in nature, sometimes it is also known as semi-synthetic fiber. It is also called semi-synthetic fiber. Why? Because the raw material which is needed for producing rayon is wood pulp, and wood pulp is a natural thing which exists in nature on its own. So since it is obtained from a naturally occurring polymer, that is why it is called semi-synthetic. So now let us look at the process. So if you talk about wood pulp, what does it contain? So if this is the wood pulp, and wood pulp contains a polymer, that is which polymer? It contains cellulose, and cellulose is a polymer. So this cellulose is then chemically converted into a soluble compound. So you see, this is how the structure of cellulose look like. So you see, it has got repeated units of monomer. So this cellulose is converted into a soluble compound by chemical reactions, and then this soluble compound is made to pass through the spinneret. So you remember the spinneret, concept of spinneret, it is nothing but a disc-like structure through which the viscous polymers are actually forced to come out of it. So they come in the form of thin fibers or filaments. So now these filaments which come out of it, they are then allowed to solidify. So they are solidified, and when they solidify completely, they form the rayon fibers. So that's how the synthetic fibers are formed. So basically, this is how the process is. So for any of the synthetic fibers, more or less the process revolves around this kind of a scenario. Now, specific types of rayon are manufactured in many different ways, like depending upon how the process is exactly happening, which are the chemical substances you are using during these chemical reactions. Depending on that, you get different types of rayon. Some of the types of rayon are viscose, modal, lyocell. These are all different examples of rayon, because in rayon also you have many subtypes. So let us now look at the advantages of rayon. What are their properties? Where are they used? Now, some of the most important properties is that they resemble silk in appearance, but at the same time they are a lot cheaper than that of silk. So they are cheaper than silk. They can be dyed in various colors. So you actually get rayon in many different colors, like red, blue, black, yellow, and so on. So due to its availability in various colors and due to its silk-like appearance, it is actually in demand for making different types of garments and clothes. It also makes very good bed sheets and carpets. So, and for that, it is often mixed with some other type of fibers also. For example, sometimes rayon is mixed up with cotton, or it is mixed up with some other type of fiber, and that's how a new type of fabric is formed. So you would have seen that many bed sheets, they have a very shiny appearance, they have a silky look. So that is due to the presence of rayon.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.